This dad is searching for a cure. His son was born with a genetic disorder called NF1. It's a common disease that affects 1 in every 3,000 people. Yet, there's no cure.
It's kind of like a closet disease where these children and adults that are afflicted with NF1, they can have tumors that grow anywhere on their body.
There are over 4,000 different mutations. You can do clinical trials because there aren't enough people like that particular child to even study drugs.
To find a cure, they need more patients. But to get more patients, they need to make them. So they're trying a controversial experiment to genetically engineer pigs to have NF1.
Using animals to help us advance research, it's hard. The last thing I want to do is harm anything. But my son, he won't be able to get the treatments that he needs. The disease picked the wrong person. I'm going to fight this tooth and nail.
This is Mason. He's got NF1, and he and his family live in Madison, Wisconsin.
As a parent, my dream for Mason is that he can just be who he is and live a happy life.
That's Mason's dad, Chuck. Mason's disease is caused by a mutation in a gene called NF1. The gene works as a tumor suppressor. So that means mutations can actually cause tumors to grow throughout the body.
When we found out, it was devastating because we went to the hospital. The oncologist said, take pictures of your son's face because more than likely it's going to be deformed. Confirming it makes it real. Whenever I see facts, I know we need to figure out a plan.
Luckily, Chuck's job is facilitating cutting-edge scientific research. Chuck discovered that what NF1 research was missing was a better model to use to study the disease. He ended up connecting with this guy. His name is Dr. Dhanu.
My entire career generally has been about finding ways to translationally model diseases.
Basically, he's an expert at using animals as models to study human diseases.
From that point forward, we started kind of devising a plan of how to create this swine model.
I often compare our genome as a book. With NF1, one letter changed. So we are trying to create that same change in the pig, so the pig now tells the same story as the person with the disease. When we first started to go down the idea of creating a pig model of NF1, I realized there are over 4,000 different mutations. A single pig just wasn't going to reflect the complexity of the disease. How are we going to do this? Genetically engineering a pig is like launching a shuttle. We needed to learn every bolt, every screw.
To create their first genetically engineered pig, Dhanu and his team decided to use a technology called CRISPR, which allows them to modify genes.
The first part is understanding the gene sequence and where are we going to create the edit.
That's what these two are doing.
So if we were to look here, so here's the locus we wanted to edit.
Okay.
After they decide where to edit the gene, they create a chemical solution that contains the gene editing CRISPR. They then collect embryos from a pig and inject those embryos with the CRISPR solution.
So I have my two needles. The one's gonna be my holding needle. It's gonna hold my embryo in place. The other one is my injection needle, which has the CRISPR reagents loaded into it.
After that, they implant the embryos in another pig, and then they wait for about 4 months for a pig to be born. And if they did everything right, they should have an NF1 pig.
So this is Tank. He is the first trained NF4 that we had.
So Tank was sort of our first achievement in terms of genetic editing. I think it means a lot because it's sort of the first step towards finding a therapy, a cure.
When Dhanu said, we're going to allow Mason to name the male boar, and I assumed he was going to name him Mr. Pig or something like that. And the first thing he said was, we need to name him Tank. You know, because this boar, he is a soldier for NF1. He's assisting us to fight, he's serving, so.
For Dhanu and his team, this is about more than just research. It's personal.
The pressure of trying to find a cure for NF1 certainly is stronger or bigger than any of the pressures we've faced about tackling anything else. My team and I have gotten to know the community.
We're really excited. Right now, I was telling everybody was that, you know, we've got a lot of ideas. We're very determined.
What we're doing here in Madison is be able to say, Dhanu and Jamie and Chuck, these are the individuals that are doing this research. That's so unique. I don't think you realize how unique that is.
We will often hear so-and-so is got an MRI and they've spotted it, something looks like a tumor. And immediately our thought is, we gotta speed up.
People that are uncomfortable with the modification of animal models, I completely understand, I really do. My first reaction when I saw the first genetically engineered pig that had NF that we developed here was a little sad. It's like, you know, we gave this poor animal neurofibromatosis, but this is going to be the link that develops some sort of a treatment or a cure for my daughter. So I would say to those folks that, you know it's a walk a mile in my shoes type of scenario.
We would like to start modeling as many children as possible. Our current goal is about 20 different models in the next couple of years.
I know a number of children and adults that are afflicted with it, and seeing the difficulties that they go through, hopefully I can assist in helping possibly find a cure. Will there ever be a cure for NF1? I don't know. Will I stop trying to find a cure? Probably not.